Ruchit Jain from Angel Broking is now with us. Good afternoon, Ruchit. A lot of earnings coming in, expiry on the way. How would you look at the next 1 hour? You think that it's best to avoid this next 1 hour and just focus on technical levels, because there can be a lot of noise either from earnings or from the F&O expiry impact?
Yeah, good afternoon, Pankaj. Pankaj, we have seen that last couple of days, Nifty has given a good bounce back from its support zone of 8300, which was a 50% retracement of the previous up move. On the upside, however, positionally, if you see, then still upside resistance is around 8480-8500, which was the support broken on with a gap down opening on Monday session. So today, next half an hour, 1 hour, I'm not expecting much downside from current levels. I believe that, you know, still upside, the market has potential to go up to at least up to 8500 in next couple of days. So said that even in today's trading session, I think we just had a gap up opening today, and the gap is just being filled as of now. That's why Nifty is trading down. But I'm not expecting much lower levels from in next 1 hour of session. And in fact, hence one can even look to buy Nifty at current levels, placing stop loss below 8370-75 for intraday.
Right. So, you know, how would you look at this market in terms of any strategy? If somebody don't want to take a directional call, any strategy that you suggest in the last 1 hour or maybe for tomorrow morning session? Because F&O expiry, a lot of people tend to do a lot of strategies in the market.
Pankaj, overall, I think we are still in a range-bound market wherein, you know, 8300 is the support and 8500 would act as a resistance. So we are not expecting any directional momentum in next, even for tomorrow, if we say next 3-4 trading sessions. So till we come out of this range, there is no clear directional momentum in markets. So probably, I think if anyone wants to play out any of the strategies, then one should take a range-bound view and play in that direction, wherein next few trading sessions, neither Nifty would cross 8500, 8520 mark, and neither it would break 8300 support mark.
Right. So it's going to be a very volatile session, some positive news, some negative news. That's what you expect?
Yes, within this range, it's going to be very volatile. Even today, just for example, we saw in the banking sector, although Bank Nifty is in a narrow range, but the banking names post result updates are volatile. Some have given quite good momentum, such as Bank of Baroda, PNB, on higher side. But in spite of that, we have seen that the index is quite range-bound. So this type of activity would continue, wherein the index would remain range-bound, but individual stocks' name would continue to be highly volatile.
Bank Nifty, how would you look at that now that PSUs have started to gain momentum?
So Pankaj, last 2-3 days, if you see, then Bank Nifty has given a bounce back from 18,200 support zone. But on the higher side, again, resistance is coming up to 18,600, 18,650, which is again that gap down opening of Monday session. So according to gap theory, even as in Nifty, even in Bank Nifty, that's going to act as a stiff resistance area. And we have seen that in spite of, you know, PSU banks giving a good rally today, this index has not moved up. That's primarily because about 70% of the constituents of Bank Nifty are from private sector banks. So we are not expecting major momentum to pick up in spite of such a rally in the PSU stocks. And as of now, in many of the stocks also seems that this moment up move in PSU banks is maybe purely because of short covering rally, wherein we have seen certain PSU banks hitting their 52-week lows and breaking the previous levels when Nifty was at 8,000. So it more seems to be a short covering rally. We are not expecting much higher levels in Bank Nifty index. 18,600, 650 could be seen by tomorrow or by early next week, where again resistance would be faced.
So, should you use these rallies in these big names like Bank of Baroda, maybe, you know, SBI, Union Bank, OBC, as you know, a shorting opportunity, or one should take some exposure on that side, or it's still too early?
It's still too early to say, you know, whether one should take this as a shorting opportunity, because if you just see the market breadth, there is advance decline ratio, it's clearly in favor of the advances. So in case if we see this momentum getting getting diverted in favor of the declines around the resistance area of 18,600, 650 in Bank Nifty and around 8,520 Nifty, then that would be a shorting opportunity. But as of now, we are watching this resistance area. So I think still some more up move is still left till this resistance or this gap area is covered. So around 8500, 8520, if market break turns negative, we have any divergence over there, then we will take decision to go short in the Nifty. But as of now, we are not suggesting to create short positions.
Right, but as you said that for PSU banking names, there is some sort of activity which is not convincing you they can go up further. Isn't it a shorting opportunity, or you're not sure whether which side it will go in the near term?
See, mainly most of the stocks, seems that except names such as Bank of Baroda, some other stocks seems that it's a short covering rallies. And generally during such movements, the moves are very sharp higher. So one should not preempt that this short covering rally would again get sold into, and this stocks would start coming down drastically. So one should not preempt, wait for some signs of reversal before creating any short positions again. And rather, Pankaj, around if Bank Nifty comes around, resist around this 18,600 and it shows any signs of reversal. So rather than going short into any of the individual names, I think it would be good opportunity to create short positions in the index itself.
Right. And what's the level if somebody creates a short in the index itself? What's the level you're looking at? Or stop losses also, if you could just share that with us.
Yeah, so in Nifty around 8520, one can create short positions since that's a gap area which was created in Monday session. And the stop loss for same would be about 8650, the recent high which was made. On the lower side, if it starts correcting from there, then probable targets, first target would be 8300, which is the support area. And if that 8300 gets breached, then 8210, 8215 could be the levels to watch for next 15-20 days.
Ruchit, just stay on with us. We are taking a quick break. Coming back, a lot of results are coming out. I want your reaction on some of the names that are reacting sharply today. Nifty is up about 45 odd points right now, 15 minutes to go, 3 p.m. I think you should have a big move coming in either which ways. That's generally the trend that you see in expiry. 46 points higher, 8,421. That's where we are. It's been unchanged in the last 15-20 odd minutes. A lot of results, especially from the mid-cap pack now coming in. So it's getting thicker and thicker for the results season. Bank of Baroda, PNB on your screen. PNB is up 6%, 146.3. That's a very, very massive move for PNB. Dr. Reddy's, of course, up 5%. Results were superb, and the name is also under-owned. Ruchit Jain is with us. Ruchit, we spoke extensively about PSU names, so let's not focus on Bank of Baroda, PNB, the move over there. Dr. Reddy's 5% higher, one of the best gainers in the pharma pack. Numbers are looking solid. Some of the others like Lupin and Sun Pharma have not reported great set of numbers, or we can say there are concerns over there about growth. In that scenario, Dr. Reddy's benefits?
Yes, Pankaj, if you just see the overall trend of this stock, Dr. Reddy, it has outperformed all the other pharma names, such as especially large cap pharma names such as Lupin, Sun Pharma. So probably the fresh investments in this sector would continue to come in the stocks which are outperforming the other names and are doing well. So this name, Dr. Reddy, still continues to be an uptrend. We have seen every correction being, getting an opportunity to accumulate or buy this stock. So on every corrective dip, we see again volumes coming in and again the stock moving higher. Even today, if you see in last two trading sessions in this up move, the volumes are quite good. So the rally is backed by good volumes, and it's not just pullback on a lower volume. So I think this name would continue to outperform the other stocks. And Dr. Reddy still from current levels also, it could cross the resistance area of 3950 and go up to 4100, 4150.
Right. So Dr. Reddy's would be a buy, right?
Yes, Dr. Reddy continues to be a buy from current level as compared to other names from this large cap pharma space.
Right. Let's talk about Cipla. That's a name that is up 3%. I'll just go to the news flow there. It's not about results, but Sandoz has received approval for a big drug that they were going to launch. It's a generic version of the drug. Why Cipla is getting excited? Because Cipla is going to supply the API for that drug. It's a $242 million drug on a 12-month basis. And the good thing is that there are no other generic players into this. And at least for the next 3 to 6 months, there will be no other generic player. And that's why margins on this drug would be very, very high. For 1 ml, that's the 1 mg, 1 ml, however size you want to take that drug into account, they are the only approval players as of now. That's Sandoz plus Cipla put together. Drug can generate potential of about $30 million with an EBITDA of $25 million. So it'll have a margin of close to about 20, 25 million, close to about 80, 90%. So it's a high margin drug for them. Not much to add, but overall, if successful for a year, it can add a lot to the bottom line. Ruchit, Cipla on charts. Again, it's a name like Dr. Reddy's that has not done well versus some of the other large cap players. Now that they are not doing well, this would also attract funds?
Bangaj, overall, the chart structure looks positive for Cipla also. This higher top, higher bottom formation has started forming again after a decent corrective action a couple of months back. So probably I think this name also would continue to do well. Even at current levels, if you see today, then the resistance area of 690-685 has been broken out with a good gap up opening. And post opening also, the volumes are coming in for buying this share. So I think even at current levels, if anyone wants, then one can initiate fresh longs in this stock with stop loss below 685. And I think on the higher side, it's quite possible in next 1 month itself, the stock could go up to 740, 750 levels.
So again, Cipla would also be a buy among the pharma pack?
Yes, Cipla and Dr. Reddy both would be buy picks among the pharma pack.
Right. Do you look at NTPC on charts? I mean, it has a lot of volume, but not a lot of price action. Do you look at NTPC? They also declared numbers. Any view on that?
Pangal, broadly, the stock has been consolidating since last few months. We have not seen any major direction momentum in this stock. On the high side, 155, 160 generally tends to act as a resistance, and 125, 130 acts as a good support. So now the stock is trading around at the lower end of the range. 125, 130 is a good support zone, and we don't think that this range would be broken. If the stock has to start a fresh uptrend, then I think this is the support zone which should not be breached. And any corrective action due to any of the news flows, if the stock again comes to in this zone of 125, 130, one should look to accumulate this stock. But again, it won't be a trading pick. It won't be a short-term buy because generally the stock does not give large movements in short-term. So probably for long-term investors, those who have a view of more than 6 months, the zone of 125, 130 support zone should be used as a buying opportunity in this.
How would you look at ITC? They also declared numbers. Numbers, of course, fundamentally were not that great, but they were expected to be on the muted side.
ITC, if you see last couple of trading sessions, it has turned quite volatile. And on the higher side, the resistance is coming around 317, 318. So I believe upside would be limited in the stock in near term. Around 317, 318, the stock would resist and again come down to 295, 290 near term. So I don't think there's much upside in this stock if anyone is looking from a short-term trading perspective. If anyone is heavy holding long, then one can look to exit from the stock around 316 to 318 range and expect lower levels around 295 again.
How would you look at HUL? That's also gaining in today. Of course, results came out quite a while back, but how would HUL look?
Even HUL has been a range-bound stock. If you see 945, 950 is acting as a resistance on the high side, and 870, 880 is the support level. So probably now the stock is at around the higher end of the range. We may see another up move up to 940, 45, which would be about 1.5% from here. But then again, it would continue to remain in that range, and it could come back to the lower end of the range. So we are not initiating any buying calls in either HUL or ITC from current levels.
NMDC, what would be your view? It's lost quite a bit actually in the last 3-4 trading sessions.
Overall, this stock has been in a downtrend, continuously forming this low top, low bottom formation. Although if we see, then it has been a good, it is a good dividend yield stock from current levels. But still, the trend is not changing, and we are not seeing any reversal of the trend. We spoke about some of the names where up moves are with good volumes. In NMDC, we have seen that the down moves are with good volume. So more of a delivery-based selling has been happening in this stock. So one should still stay away from this stock. One should still not be in a hurry to do any kind of bottom fishing unless there are any signs of reversal.
Right. That also goes true for all the other metal names as well, names like Tata Steel, Hindalco.
I think in Hindalco is one of the stock where downside could be limited from current levels. If I just observe the long-term charts of Hindalco, then since 2010, the stock is trading in a broad triangle and prices are now at the lower end of the triangle. So I think downside could be limited in this stock. However, still said that there are no near-term triggers wherein the stock looks an attractive buy. But still, one should not create any short positions in Hindalco as of now. So I think the downside could be limited in Hindalco, but other names such as NMDC could continue to go further down from current levels.
How would you look at DLF? It was up 6% yesterday. It's up 6% today as well at 110. DLF is at least off the lows of 94, 95 that it had made.
Yeah, it's turned quite volatile after being news in since yesterday second half of trading session. But if I just ignore that news part and just see purely on a technical basis, then the resistance is coming around 112, 115 range. So it needs to cross that resistance area and sustain above that for any kind of fresh buying trigger. So far in spite of the stock giving a bounce back from lows of 98, 99, it's near to this resistance area of 112, 115. And if that resistance area is get crossed, then we may see some further buying coming in the stock. But as of now, rather than taking any call over here, I would wait for this resistance zone of 150 to get crossed in the stock.
Most of the other real estate names are also doing well. Anything that you can identify in the CNX Realty Index or real estate name overall?
Overall, charts of India Bulls real estate seems better than any other names in this pack. If you just observe India Bulls real estate, then in last couple of months, couple of weeks, it is outperforming the other stocks within the sector, where we have seen 52 weeks low getting hit in names such as DLF, SDIL, in other names. We've seen this stock has steadily performed and it has remained sideways, at least it's not correcting. So now when the stocks have started moving up, this was the outperformer and has started started forming this higher top, higher bottom. So on the upside, I think 64, 65 is first resistance. And once it get crossed, the stock has potential to go up to 70 rupees in near term. So India Bulls real estate looks good from this pack, which could continue to outperform the other names in the sector.
Ruchit, Jet Airways, of course, it's not seeing action today, but it was up 20% yesterday, 10% day before. You think that there is some action over there? I mean, generally, you would not look at it. It's not in the part of F&O. But if you could just look at the charts and tell me how Jet Airways is looking, are you getting signs that the worst is behind?
These stocks generally move in inverse correlation with the crude oil prices also. And we have seen since crude oil prices are still under pressure and are still not showing any signs of reversal or any uptrend, I think downside would be limited in this stock. And yesterday it had also given a breakout from a falling trendline resistance. So I think Jet Airways could do well in near term. We have even seen SpiceJet doing well in last 1 month. So I think these airline names could do well going ahead from short term perspective. Jet Airways 340 is a good support level for this stock. So around 360, if the stock comes, then it would again be a good buying opportunity from trading perspective. Keep stop loss below 340 and the stock, I think, should go up to 400, 410 in near term.
So it's still in a buy zone as far as charts are concerned. It's not pointing out towards any weakness or long-term weakness?
No, it's still in a buy zone. Rather, I won't focus much on the long term in this chart as of now. But for short-term traders who are looking from trading perspective, I think around 360, it's a good opportunity for them to go long.
Right. Just a last word on names like Reliance Infra, Arcom, again, very high beta name. They are doing very well today. Rel Infra is up 6, Arcom is up 5. Some of the other ADAG pack also seem to be doing well.
Mangesh, from ADAG pack, we are liking this Reliance Capital from current levels. If I just pull up the weekly or monthly charts of this stock, then it is giving a pullback from this rising trendline support. And now it's showing signs of strength with increasing volumes. Although these names, Reliance Infra, Reliance Capital, have been a lot volatile in the recent past. But I think Reliance Capital could give a decent up move going ahead. So any kind of down moves around 375, 370 should be a good buying opportunity in this stock. Downside in the stock is limited up to 340, 350, and we don't think that the stock would now correct much from current levels.
Ruchit, thank you so much for joining us here this afternoon. Hope you have a great day going ahead. 30-odd minutes remaining for the expiry this series. Generally, the action starts about 25 minutes before. 60 points higher, I think the action little bit has started. We've started to inch up just a little bit. Let's take a break. We'll be back in 2 minutes. We'll be having a FNO guest on the other side of this break.